Joining us now is Rhode Island State Representative Patricia Serpa from District 27 in West Warwick, Warwick and Coventry. She is also chairwoman of the House Oversight Committee. Pat, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you so much for inviting me, Rainer. I'm happy to share my story.
Now, from what I understand, recently you took quite a tumble. Now, we can see that your eye is pretty beat up there. Can you tell me what happened and what landed you in the Kent emergency room?
Sure, I'll be happy to tell you of my unfortunate situation. We're having some new steps put on the back of our house leading down to our patio, and I've been used to those steps there for 35 years. So the carpenter came, removed the steps, and he said, I'll be back on Monday to put the steps in. So Sunday morning, I opened the door to go out and feed the birds, as I do every morning. And just assuming that the steps were there, I took a step, out I went, and I hit the cement pavement. It was about a 6 or 7 foot fall because there were no steps there. So this is the result, and falling on my right side, I really hit the ground. So it wasn't funny.
So clearly, you're pretty banged up, and you had to go to the Kent Hospital emergency room. Were you hesitant at all, or happy to go to the emergency room and seek care?
I'm going to be honest with you, Raina. I was very hesitant because I have a husband here with an underlying medical condition, and I have a 95-year-old mother here that, you know, I'm trying to protect from the coronavirus. But the neighbor who helped scrape me off the cement and helped me walk into the house, and my husband insisted that I go. And sometimes an injury is beyond yourself. And as I said, I was more worried about them. So my husband said, well, I'm going to call the rescue with or without your cooperation. So I knew my goose was cooked. So I got into the rescue, and you know, the West Warwick firefighters, as usual, were wonderful. They wheeled me into the ER at Kent, and I've been there before with my husband and other family members. And as usual, they were gracious, attentive, and it's always in Rhode Island. My attending nurse was a former student of mine. So I said to her, was I nice to you in school? She said, yes, you were. And I said, oh, thank goodness, you know, because payback can be a son of a gun. So, you know, she set me up, started the IV, very attentive, made me very comfortable, gave me the heated blankets, took my vitals. And the first thing I said to the doctor who saw me, I believe he was a resident, but I'm not sure. I was very upfront and honest with him. I said, you know, and he saw the bruise on my head. And I said, you know, doctor, I was hesitant to come. I said, I know I probably have a concussion, which I did. I said, but I was hesitant to come because of the coronavirus. And I told him my story of having a husband with an underlying condition at home and a 95-year-old mother that I'm doing my best to keep safe. So I didn't want my visit to the emergency room to be the thing that put them in jeopardy after 2 months. So he said, I understand your concerns. He said, I can assure you, Mrs. Serpa, that we as a staff feel very, very safe here. He said, and I understand your fears, and they're not unrealistic fears. He said, but the rooms that we have for the patients who think might be COVID positive are off in another section, far away from where we are here. And I had a curtained stall. And there's some kind of a special piping that they put into those rooms. I don't know how many they are, so that the air that circulates in those rooms where patients are suspected that they're corona positive, none of that air circulates out into the ER where the rest of us are. He said some special plumbing has been put and piping has put in so that all of the air leaves the building. So he said, if you were my mother, I would tell you, don't worry about it. He said, you should feel safe. And, you know, that was kind of all I needed, because if the doctor tells you to feel safe, and, you know, and I asked my little nurse friend, Amy, my former student, I said, should I be worried about being here? She said, Mrs. Serpa, not at all. I wouldn't be here working if I thought that was the case.
So you feel pretty happy with the care you received at Kent?
Absolutely. I've never had bad a bad experience there. And it's been my husband who's mostly gone there, my son a couple of times. They were very attentive. The facility was immaculate, and I could tell it was recently cleaned. Everything in the stall that I was in was clean. The doctor came in and discussed my injuries. He was very thorough, and he expressed his concern. Not only was he worried about my head, but he was worried about my hips, my pelvis. So I had a CAT scan of my head, my neck, and my spine, because, I mean, I landed on the cement. And then they x-rayed, and I might have x-rayed my hip and my knee, because I showed him the position that my neighbor picked me up from. And so he was very, very thorough. And I have to say, I didn't feel that I waited an overly long time to get into x-ray and to get into CAT scan and for them to get the results back to the attending physician. And he came right in and he said, well, he says, we have all good news. Nothing is broken. He said, but you know, you do have a concussion. And he told me all of the things to watch out for. And I knew those signs.
Tell me some words that you would tell a person ready to go into the ER if they were feeling nervous.
I would say, take it from one who has been there and done that. And I've got an elderly person living with me and someone with an underlying condition. So I would understand their reluctance. And I commiserate with them. I certainly can appreciate that. But I would say, take it from me. If I had gotten into that facility and I felt the least bit threatened or unsafe or it wasn't clean, I would have hightailed it out of there, Raina, fast, quick, and in a hurry. I would have called someone to say, just come and get me. I'm not staying here. And, I openly expressed my fears. And I think that's the best thing you can do. Tell the doctors and tell the nurses not only how you're feeling, but what you're afraid of. I mean, and there are consequences to my bringing home the corona to my loved ones. And fortunately, I felt very comfortable. So I would say to anybody, don't hesitate. If you have fallen or you're having chest pains or you think something is wrong with you, don't stay away out of fear, because I think it really could have dramatic negative consequences. And in fact, Raina, I was going to wait till the next day. I was arguing with my husband and my neighbor. I said, well, I won't go today. Let me see how the day goes. And if I don't feel any better today, I'll go tomorrow. But, and I know better, because with a head injury, you don't wait 24 hours. So I knew I was wrong.
Well, Pat, we're really glad to hear you received excellent care at Kent Hospital. You look great. I mean, I know you have the black eye, but your hair is done, your makeup looks great, and you look like you're doing well.
Thank you. I'm saving on eye makeup, Rainer. I only have to put it on one eye.
I have enough makeup on for both of us, Pat, so don't worry about it.
Okay. Well, you look great. So.
Thank you.
But no, don't hesitate.
Rhode Island State Representative Patricia Serpa, District 27 in West Warwick, Coventry, and Warwick, also chairwoman of the House Oversight Committee. Thank you so much for sharing your story with us today.